Hey guys, I'm Angelo, and welcome back to Crypto Coin Consultants. Today I'll be going through the motions of how to participate in an ICO. Let's get started. Most ICOs require your investment to be in the form of Ether. So the first step is to purchase Ether on Coinbase or GDAX, which I showed you how to do in my videos on how to trade on exchanges. You'll want to purchase an amount that's slightly over the amount that you're willing to invest, as you'll have to pay a nominal amount in gas. So if you want to invest one Ether, I'd recommend purchasing 1.01 Ether just to be on the safe side. Once you've acquired Ether, you'll have to create a wallet for it. The most common place to do so is MyEtherWallet.com, also commonly referred to in the crypto community as Mu. When you get to the homepage, create a custom password for yourself. Then click Create New Wallet. You'll then be taken to a screen where you can download what's called a key store file, which is a file encrypted by the password you chose. Make sure to download this file and secure it in a safe place. Then click I understand, continue. The next screen that appears will show you your private key. As with the key store file, write it down and save it in a secure place. Now there are two ways to log into your Mu: your private key or a combination of your password plus key store file. Selecting key store file prompts us to select the file we downloaded, then decrypt it using the password we chose. Selecting private key simply requires us to enter the private key assigned to us just a few moments ago. Once we're in, you'll see your wallet's address that you have to send your Ether to at the center and on the right. Keep in mind that all Ether addresses will always begin with a 0x. Below your address is your account balance, and scrolling even further down shows you the balances of all the ERC20 tokens you hold. Copy your address and go back to GDAX or wherever else you purchased your Ether, then send the amount of Ether you want to invest into the ICO over to your Mu. The reason why we want to send our Ether from our Mu to the ICO address rather than from GDAX is because you're required to send Ether from an address to which you own the private keys. You do not own the private keys to an exchange like GDAX. Also, the token you're purchasing will likely be sent back to the same address from which you sent your Ether. Unlike GDAX, Mu is able to recognize and differentiate one ERC20 token from another. Next step is to open up the website of the ICO you'd like to buy into. You can track current ongoing ICOs at icotracker.net/current, which I'll link to in the description below. Let's use Electron World Money as an example, or EWM. I have to note though that I'm using EWM as an arbitrary example purely for demonstrational purposes. I have no plans on buying into EWM, and none of what you see in this video should be taken as financial advice. Once you're on the site, you'll want to navigate to the section that shows information on where to send your Ether. Copy the address and go back to your Mu. Click Send Ether and Tokens. Note that you'll have to log back in again using your credentials. And paste the address into the To Address field. One way to verify that this is a real address is if a colored image appears in this circle. Do not send off your Ether if you don't see this. Enter the amount you want to send, and again, remember to have a little bit of extra Ether in your account to pay for gas fees. And enter the gas limit as recommended on the ICO's webpage. Then click Generate Transaction. Doing so will prompt a light blue bar to appear at the bottom like this. Clicking on it will further prompt a pop-up to appear like this, which acts as a last confirmation that you want to go through with this transaction. Click on it to finally send it off. Tokens from the ICO can be distributed either instantly or may take some time, depending on how they've structured it. As I said earlier, your tokens will be sent back to the same Mu address that you sent your Ether from. Knowing this, you'll now have to create a custom token in your Mu in order to view your token balance from this ICO. To do so, scroll down in Mu and click on Add Custom Token. Information for each of the fields that appears should be provided by the ICO, either on their website, their Medium blog, or even their Twitter. Going back to our EWM example, we'll navigate back over to their site, copy the token contract address, use the EWM token symbol, and use 18 decimals. Paste the token contract address into the proper field. Enter EWM as a symbol, enter 18 decimals, and click Save. You'll now be able to view your EWM balance whenever the tokens are sent back to you, along with the balances of all the other ERC20 tokens you hold. And just like that, you've participated in your first ever ICO. Keep in mind that the exchange that provides the most immediate liquidity for your ERC20 tokens is Ether Delta, where the tokens are traded exclusively against Ether. It's not until they're listed on a major exchange like Bittrex or Binance that they'll be available to trade against Bitcoin as well. That's all there is, guys, to participating in an ICO. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them in the comment section below, and I'll do my best to answer them to the best of my ability. Enter Blockport and Capdax. These two interesting up-and-coming contenders have made it clear that they've taken a close look at both Bittrex and Binance, and that their goal is to learn from the irreversible mistakes those two have made. I truly believe they'll be offering much better and more innovative products that, in my opinion,